not loud enough. Just trying to hear myself. Okay, let's open one bag. Let's open our free bag and daily bag. Free goodie bag. Just one tile. Come on. Poppy, alright. Perfect. Do I need this at all? Can you hear dogs? Because I can hear dogs. Dogs in the neighborhood. Hey. Fitness instructor. I can work on fitness instructor. Excuse me, allergy. And I'll go ahead and finish the quest. I'll jump into arena. So this is a useful pattern. Early in the day, doing the quests, going to buy three things. Open the bags and buy three things. I will start working on some more ash tiles or something else. I think the ash tiles will be helpful. I can change my mind later. I can try to save more arena coins. I can try to earn more arena coins. I can't. I can't hear my playback very well. All right, let's try to fix this. Is this positioned wrong? Hello. Arena battles. Or should I spend energy first? I'll spend a little bit of energy first. So, I'm still working on the pirates. I'm getting very close to 4 stars, and I'll go up to 5 stars. I'll just do the max loot. Okay, that's good. That's very, very close. Very close. I need 3 more tiles for 4 stars. Then I'll keep going up to 5 stars. Okay, so it's the same arena team, same old. The only choice is whether to bring Princess Argenta, whether to bring Hiker, or whether to bring Lloyd. Sassy spirit villain. How good is this castle team without Burnabas? You know what? It's not that good, but it's only 4 ranks. I want more than a few ranks if I can. I wonder if I can take on Fearless Jet Desperado. It's not that much awesomeness difference, but that's a high-powered Lloyd with Yuppie backup and the Highwayman. It's kind of tough. And since those matches can be annoying, when I can avoid it, I will. I'll not play the lower awesomeness theme, lower than mine. Now that I'm up to 112,000. Okay, good. Let's just take on this one. Not the Asphalt Paladin. I'll take on Cabin Wise Guy. I can take this. And it'll be good. I won't bring Hiker. And let's see now. First target, let's go for Reed. I will just make a quick stream announcement in the middle of playing this. Okay, focus on Reed. There's only one space hero, space foe on the other side, so he won't be super fast. Alright, I just knocked him out before Hiker can heal him. Can I? You know what, I'll take one more turn before tanking up with Lloyd, and question is, do I target Hiker? Okay. Okay, this will provide some healing just in time. I'll go ahead and heal Argenta. So I don't need to tank right away. I'll do it on Lloyd's turn. I'll go ahead now. Yeah, Argenta needed that healing. Let's do this. Big damage from Princess Argenta. Heal up Lloyd. And try to take out Hiker before he heals. This'll do it. Probably way too much damage. As you see. Get him out of there. And then let's go to Cactus Girl. Yeah, this was pretty easy, maybe too easy. I think I can do some teams at around 15,000 awesomeness higher, thereabouts. So that would be nearly 130,000 awesomeness. Like 128,000 awesomeness. See, I'm stingy with my healing, if you notice. I'm not targeting Verda, cause she's just gotta go into stealth. And this will allow me to hit her if I remove Fitness Instructor. I'm pretty stingy with healing. Since if they don't do that much damage, then I don't need that much healing. Just how it is. Let's go to the general LEGO Legacy chat. Chat. Discord. And announce it. So, was this too easy? We want a more challenging fight. Okay. I gotta retitle this stream. Go to the dashboard. Hold on. Okay, how far along is my Captain Redbeard? That's how I tell how long I've been playing. So he said 5 stars. 5 stars, 690. Tiles plus 17. And today's tiles will be 220. No, 210. Oh, it's divided by 3. That's 70 days. Can't think of a good title for just a regular playing. This will do. Okay. If you haven't joined my Discord yet, the information is in the description. And yeah, please like and follow and subscribe if you can. You don't have to. I'm just starting out pretty much. It would help a lot to get some followers, some follows. Yeah? So I'll post a link to my own stream Discord to the chat. Okay. Alright, ready to go. I'm not gonna accelerate my next arena battle. I'll just do daily quests for 2.5 minutes and event. So I'm thinking of doing another node in Piptown. This level 52. I mean the opponent minifigure level is 52 and my level is 50. I need builders. I can bring an ally jester from my guild. I have a little bit of healing, not that much. I have a good attacker in Ashe. I have a lot of tanking and support, so no healer tag, but some healing. I think I can bring the lighthouse because I got a role model. Is that the best set I can bring? Seeing as I can only bring builder sets. This is the Kaboom Moon story. Sure, Poppy. Alright, everyone knows what this storyline is referencing. The dialogue can be, well, quite odd. So what's the first target? You've got some space heroes. I'll go for Captain Valiant to get their tank out of the way, I guess. I could make someone else clumsy, but I haven't fully upgraded Magisto, so the clumsy chance isn't that high. I'll wait before I start tanking. I'll let them take some damage. I'll let my side take some damage. I'll do my damage first. They don't have a real healer. They have Captain Valiant as their healer, which is okay. So we're mostly at full health. This will give critical chance up. I'll just do as much damage as I can. However, I should start tanking up with either Lloyd or Valiant soon. Not immediately. And then Jester Gogo will be my final tank, final taunt when everyone else needs healing. So I guess I'll go ahead and do this. Lloyd doesn't do that much damage. He does less damage than Burnabas. I'll wait before targeting someone with Magisto's healing. And I'll hope to get some Courage Tokens before firing off the Power Wash special, which does damage based on Courage Tokens. Health up and healing on Lloyd. I'm gonna risk letting Lloyd tank one more round before tanking with Burnabas and then tanking with Jester Gogo. So a little more healing. And who's their most damaging attacker? I want Reed out and take a quick look at his abilities. So he can stun, but it's not 100%. Now I taunt. So we're trying to do as efficient taunting as possible. Again, well, Magisto failed to apply Clumsy. Instead, he missed. So we'll let Burnabas tank, take some damage, take several hits, and try to cycle through to the cooldown of Fitness Instructor's healing. They don't have any healing, so if I spread some damage, it'll stay. If Burnabas gets too low, then I will have to taunt with Jester Gogo. I can wait one more turn, I believe. Your next attacker is Dwayne, who isn't very fast. He does a fair amount of damage, so take him out next. And there's no second wave here. So what you see on the field, those are the enemies. I'm gonna stealth and then taunt with Jester Gogo. Okay, we're looking good to get the gold trophy. I target Kelvin or Kartofsky. I should take note of how much damage they do. I'll go ahead and taunt now, even though Lloyd's at more than half health of his full health. And I'll give payback to did I target Magisto? I was supposed to target Jester Gogo. It's a bit of a misclick, but no matter. I'll double taunt here. Overlapping taunts. It's good against AI. They spread the damage sometimes. And it gives attack down. And now, how much will this do? I need to upgrade Ash more. The damage isn't so great yet. She should be doing more than 2,000. Maybe at her third star, she'll be much better. Health up on Gogo.
Is that a doorbell?
Okay, Private. That's a doorbell. That's a doorbell.
Hope someone answers it.
I guess I can, if you don't mind, I'll go check it out. If it rings one more time, I'll have to check that doorbell. Now I don't have to heal, I don't have to taunt, I don't have to do anything but damage. Alright, this is, I guess, just the right level to pass this node with the gold trophy. Okay, someone should be answering the door. I don't have to. I think I'd better check it though. Oh well. Play an auto. Be right back. Sorry about that. Okay. It was a doorbell. And they got the wrong house. That's what house numbers are for. They got the wrong house. Okay. Gonna play arena. What's with the face nonsuch? Alright, we've got some new pirates coming to the game. It should be the next event. It won't be a big time fancy event. Just be a few nodes. What they call an unboxed event. That should be coming pretty soon with some, and there will be some more changes in the coming updates. I think one of those changes will be to arena payouts. You might be able to select the time of your arena payout. Right now the time's not a bad schedule for me. It could be a little better. All right. So I'm pretty far from the bottom of Silver 1, which is top 500. So I'm not really incentivized to go up a lot of ranks. But what do I want? Do I really want a powerful Lloyd as an enemy. The darn dog scratched me on the chest. Right here. Ow. How about this? Pirate team looks tough. All the teams look tough at this level. Some of these teams could make it to the top 100 if they tried a little harder. Of the full pirate team with Valiant, you know, I'll take on the full pirate team. Let's see how it goes. Oh wow, can't target it. I'll take on the full Kingsguard team. No, it's got Headley instead of Princess Verda, so they don't have much damage. I'll take it on. Yeah, and I won't bring. I still won't bring Hiker. I'm double tanking. And we have three pirates. I've seen in some Discord chats that Barnabas and Lloyd don't have synergy. I disagree when they're on player control. If you bounce around their tanking abilities, their taunt and Lloyd's stealth, if you bounce them around and use healing properly, they complement each other quite well. You just need some healing to back it up. Without healing, the two of them don't really, they don't do great. Not sure I should have cleared the taunt on Jester. Now here's a lack of synergy. It's three tanks, one of them not a pure tank, and Jester Go-Go. Three of them taunting practically at the same time. That's something you don't have to do. I'm going to tank up now. And let's keep targeting Barnabas. He's a lot more threatening than Headley. We can ignore Headley since the other two will taunt frequently. I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to Jester Go-Go. Jester's getting the taunt from King Brutus on this turn. Jester Go-Go happens to be standing in the fifth spot on the opponent's team, which means I'll just take out Go-Go. Which means because of the AI, Crown King Brutus automatically tanks in order, slot 5 then slot 4. I believe that's what I've seen and other people have reported. Okay, let's try to dizzy the Master Barnabas. Save my Dragon Master. And see if we can finish this off. Already have the advantage in numbers. And as long as Barnabas is dizzy, you see the Ring of Stars dizzy icon. As long as he's dizzy, he cannot counter. Even if he has that payback from Magisto. Let's see if okay, I cleared taunt from Headley. Even though I missed, Lloyd still healed, so we're okay, but I do need to heal some more. I will heal Barnabas. And taunt. And then I'll go ahead and finish off Headley since he's gonna get taunt again. I wonder if he does the redundant taunt ability or if AI has learned not to do that. Okay, I might lose a tank, but we're good. I believe Brutus will even give taunt to Magisto the way they stand. Well, it has self-heal. It's very useful. Lost my tank. And we're good. Play it on auto. Okay. There we go. Does that do it? That should do it. Of course you dodged that one. Okay, we're getting closer to the top 100. I wonder how many days it'll take me to get there. That's also an achievement to unlock. Let's see. I just unlocked Magisto at 4 stars. And I have a bunch of achievements I can do pretty soon. They're not gonna get me 75 Magisto tiles. To do that, I have to play a lot longer. So I played for 70 days, or at least 70 Redbeard daily rewards. Let's go to the challenge missions. I believe I can maybe get close to this. Let's bring Lloyd for longevity on my tanks. I should be close to beating this. I'm at level 50. But they do a lot of damage. I remember like my last try. Yeah, that highwayman's a problem. Oh well, I'll go ahead and stealth. And heal. Their cook Bart might be able to heal this damage that I'm doing now. Redbeard heals something. Okay. Yeah, that's a big heal. I have my own healing. Question is, can I finish them off? And Redbeard, I need to target because he enables the other pirates and he counters when a pirate takes damage. So I do have to target Redbeard first. I think I'm gonna be close. I might not get the gold trophy to be able to loot this. I should win. I should win this. I have enough healing. Maybe. They have healing too. I would target Highwayman, but they have a cook Bart, so I'll target the next best damage dealer on their side, and I'll go ahead and self heal. I'll also spam my healing. Let's take out Argenta before Bart gets healing back. It's probably a 2-turn cooldown on Bart's healing. I should watch more carefully. That takes care of Argenta. Let's ignore Darwin. Uh-oh. Save my tank. Save Barnabas. And just doing the maximum damage, even though they don't have debuffs on them, so the abilities of Burnabas and Bart were not fully maximized there, but it's okay. I'm forced to target Bart, because if I target someone else, Bart will just heal them up. And prepare for more tanking. Lloyd has dodged up and dodged down. Sort of canceling. And I'll wait on the tanking, the taunting. Self-heal. Try to remove Cook Bart. This should do it. And now I'll do as much damage to Highwayman as I can when he comes out of stealth. Here you go, Highwayman. Take that. Take that, I say. I'll do the attack down and heal. So I disagree that Burnabas and Lloyd don't go well together on a pirate team. They do go well together with Cook Bart especially, and Hiker adds even more tankiness to that by healing them up. So you see, I took a ton of damage to both of my tanks and no damage to my other minifigures, and I healed up all of the damage they took. Take him out of stealth. That will lower his damage. Go ahead and heal up Lloyd and then stealth Burnabas next turn, if there's a next turn. So I've attempted this challenge before my minifigures were at level 50, and I've failed it. So level 50 is where it becomes possible to beat a gold, I suppose. Maybe 49, I don't know. Maybe I didn't try it at 49. Okay, that's another daily quest done. So we're just jumping around today and going all around the map. It's time for me to use some of my mashup energy. Go to Monolith Waste. And maybe I'll just loot around here. Can I play this node yet? I might try it later. Let's just try to level up Forbidden Island. I need 8 tiles. I need 8 out of 9 loots to produce a tile now. 8 out of 8 to level up. Just got 2. Need 6 more. I won't get that even if I refresh. It won't happen. So I have to wait another day. Use on Brick Separator. Is there a particular set we want to target? If I want coffee, I'll go to the Lego house. How about Lofty Crab plants and lofty flintlock bits? Got coins instead. It's a good idea to spread around your brick separators somewhat, just so that you don't get too much of the same piece of gear. There, I needed that. I know I needed that. I need a few more. So let's target Traitor Transport when we can. Got an achievement. Got 2 Magisto tiles out of 75. It's definitely possible to get those 75 tiles. It'll take a long time though. Have to win maybe 1,000 arena battles. And do a bunch of tasks that take time to finish. Like using shared guild heroes. Take a quick look at their roster. So, the top 6 are what I'm bringing to Arena. I still need to gear them up some more. So I'll use some energy on their gear. And there are some abilities I can improve. I won't use these valuable and rare elixirs just for 10% more damage. This one, I could improve. I'll hold back. I'll also hold back on these. This is quite nice. That I want to accumulate more elixirs before committing to an upgrade. I use up all my elixirs. I won't be able to decide on a different upgrade. Like this one. So I want to accumulate enough for 2 upgrades before doing 1 upgrade. Generally. Or at least get close. Since it's not critical to improve my arena squad at this time, I'm pretty safely in the top 500 and not yet close to the top 100. Now, I just beat this tier the last time I played this, and I haven't done it on stream, so I'll show how it can be done with just 3. I've also tried and failed with 2, I believe. 3 is the right number of castle minifigures. And I'll start with Aurora. I think it's very hard to beat with just 2. So I've gotta use some of my XP scrolls to further level up my builders for the Piktown United campaign. Cause I think I need a few more nodes in there. That Aurora is coming back. I think it will come back, yes. And gonna self-heal too. Go ahead and take her out again. I might have to do some taunting here. I'll heal up first. Burnabas. In a couple of turns, I will put Verda in stealth so she can heal. I'll just take out the Aurora. Didn't get clumsy, but it's okay. Next step. Let's target Kelvin. Kelvin with dodge down. I'll stealth Verda to heal. Hey! eliminate the Kelvin. Yeah, let's try it. Kelvin comes back. I have to take out that Aurora. Gotta try to tank again. Start targeting Aurora. I believe Explorer Aurora prioritizes healing low health characters before she revives defeated minifigures. So as long as there are minifigures with low health, she won't revive. One thing I can do if I want Aurora not to heal herself, and I can't, if I couldn't take her down with one hit, I could try to hit another target to lower health in Aurora, and not defeat them. That way Aurora will not heal herself, she will heal the other target. So, as you can see, I'm pretty low in health, which means I couldn't have done this with just two of my minifigures. And if they were slightly less upgraded, probably wouldn't get the gold trophy. This is exactly enough. Okay, that gives me a lot of scrolls, and I can do some leveling up. Let's just finish the dailies, though. I need some Pit Town United missions. Can I do 6.6? There's a chance. Shall I try? I think I will first clear the daily quest. Come on, Darwin. I know you're in there. It's one more tile. Okay. So it's 70 days, maybe 71, that I've played this account. If you don't know, this is not my main account. My main account I've been playing since August. This one since January. Middle of January. Based on Redbeard. Okay, let's see what we can upgrade. I said Ash could use more damage. This'll increase it to 170% damage. Plus 20% for each Saga Courage. I want her to gain courage a little faster. This helps. First Responder passive. This ability is upgraded pretty high already. I don't have that many elixirs to spend. And this has a chance to make her go faster. That's what you want in an attacker. Speed and damage. Speed times damage means more damage. Let's see if I can find this piece of gear. Yeah, I can loot it now. But I only have 18 energy. I'll have to buy energy. If I want to play more nodes. I guess I should upgrade this to make her actually useful. Her passive has to be higher up. At least to level 3. Level 4 would be nice. Especially if I have a city tank. Which would mean I need to upgrade a city tank. I'll go ahead and do that. Will I take her up to level 3? How important is she for the builder campaign? She's going to be the best attacker. I'll go ahead and do it. She doesn't have any benefit from increasing her skill. The only reason to equip that gear is to gear her to gear 6. So I do need those fancy flintlock plans before I consider building, assembling the gear pieces. This will take half of my scroll bank to get her to level 50. Will I do it? I think I will. Still a lot of scrolls. Can get someone else to level 50 probably, or at least 49. I just need 34 tiles to get her to star 4. Star 4. So I'll just focus on Lloyd and Ashe with my arena coins for now. I'll eventually get Valiant. He only takes 30 tiles to unlock. And I'll ignore King Brutus for a while. I think I don't really need him. Since I won't get 5 castle heroes to 5 stars anytime soon, anyway, I won't try for Brutus. Might even be able to get Magisto to 5 stars before I get Brutus. I think Brutus might be the weakest, or at least the most narrow minifigure in the arena shop. I prefer Lloyd for now, and Firefighter Ashe. Valiant, Captain Valiant has uses, but I don't think he's as versatile as Lloyd. He's nice if you want a tank that's also kind of a healer. But for that purpose, you have Jester Gogo and Dragonmaster Burnbus together with Magisto, which is the most commonly seen at the top of the arena leaderboards. Partly because it's pretty hard to beat the three King's Court. The King's Court trio, Magisto, Burnimus, Gogo. It's pretty hard to beat them in 5 minutes if they're leveled all the way up. They can be beaten, for sure. But with some luck, with some dodges, it can be tricky to win in 5 minutes. If you're not really powered up. A powered up pirate squad can take on the city team. Who else do I want to upgrade? I can upgrade Magisto a little? Or fitness instructor? Get him to 49 and get fitness instructor up to 50. Or you can split it. So let's filter for builders because I want to advance in Piptown United some more. I believe I can get more upgrades out of my builders than I can upgrading my explorers, since I have several explorers already at level 50. I think I can get more mileage out of upgrading builders. Shall I try Street Sweeper Sal? I'll get to 40 something, 43. I do also need to consider events, like city tags for events. I'll focus on five builders first. One of them is Firefighter Ash. Burnabas, yeah, Lloyd. Burnabas, Lloyd, Ash. Two tanks go with Ash. Magista goes with Burnabas. That's four. Now it's Fitness Instructor for a little healing. Or Jester Gogo for some healing too. I think I can get more out of upgrading Fitness Instructor. I want her healing to be better, although her attack stat doesn't matter much. Let's see, let's look at her gear upgrades. This is something I can do. Do I want... I do want to bring Fitness Instructor for the campaign. I could cut Magisto and bring Gogo if Gogo surpasses Magisto. But I think this is fine. I don't need to bring Princess Verda. I can go for Fitness Instructor. Let's get her up. Let's get her up to 49. And I can still level up Magisto to 48. Shall I do it? And let's improve this healing a little. Okay. Now I think I can take on the next node. It will require a guild ally. Shall I get Storm? I think I like Storm.